What's up, YouTube? Today, I'm gonna be installing some gauges on the White Tiger.
So here's my package. This should be my gauges. I ordered two of them from, can't remember the name of it, Air Force. Let's go ahead and see what they look like. This sucks. Also more. There they are. Man, this is gonna look good. These are all the different options I had when I ordered them. Except for these. These are actually if you bought them from the manufacturer, which I bought these through Fastech. And I'm starting to wonder if I should have gotten the red, but no, my interior's black and blue, so I'm gonna I went with the black and blue display. You can see there's some other things you can buy to other sensors. I think one of those soon. Well, hopefully soon. One day. One day. Really don't want to like turn this sideways and drop it all. My look. So they got the black faces on. They said that they can come with the white faces too, so I could have the blue display with the white face, or I could have one white, one black. I'm sorry, I gotta keep it all black. It's gonna match the interior nicely. I got two of those. I have my OBD2 input with two connectors for both gauges. That makes it really easy to install. Then I also have some auxiliary ports. Got two, one for each one. And these where I can plug into boost gauge and whatever else I want to put in there, which I'll just have to determine later. But yeah, these look great. It says Air Force right here, but I've seen some on their website where you can get to say SS or whatever you want. Time to put them in. A lot of pressure to get off. This little piece right here came off with it. Just pop it back in if you need to. And it goes to that little piece right there. Before you take it all the way out too, you'll find this piece attached to that. Just pull the airbag. Don't rip that out with it too. Jeez, I hate this. Yeah, when you install the new gauge pods, you'll have to hook that back up. Piece off right here. It wasn't bad, it just has a couple pieces to it, and actually accesses the fuse box. And I would recommend taking this off before the A-pillar. Next, I'm gonna run the wire up through here up into the A-pillar area. Alright, and I prematurely put these on the A-pillar piece I got. I couldn't wait any longer to see what they look like. Anyways, that's how they look. I went ahead and plugged them in the back. I like how they have these. It helps support it pretty well. And I went ahead and put the auxiliary pieces on there too. They're just gonna hang for now, but I have them there when I need them. This is that clip that you're gonna put this back on. The airbag sensor. With these auxiliary cords, as a precaution, I did tape them up so there won't be any chance of them shorting out. And I'll put that together. Only thing is, when you do it, be careful with that A-pillar. I've scratched all this up. It's, hopefully you can't see it behind the pillars, but I've scratched all that up. It looks really good so far.
If you like this video, please like and subscribe, and I'll see you next time.